Yo, what is good, YouTube, and welcome back to another JC2K video. And in today's video, we are doing gameplay with the brand new 100 overall Shaquille O'Neal, the second 100 overall card in the history of my team. And I do believe he is a slightly worse version of Kareem in a lot of ways. I think Kareem is a slightly better card, but I think obviously as 100 overall, he is still going to be extraordinarily overpowered, and I am excited to use this card. Obviously, as I have stated in basically all of my videos this weekend, I hate this style of content. I do not like the gambling only aspect of it whatsoever, and I do not at all encourage anybody to open packs, but I am interested to try out this Shaq card, and we're going to give him a chance and see how good he is at the position. Before we hop into the video, if you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Help me push towards the 20,000 subscriber mark on the channel. I upload every single day, and I would really appreciate it if y'all do subscribe. Trying to hit 20K by the end of February, which gives us a few more days, but we're less than 200 subscribers away. So I think we're going to do it. Would really appreciate it if y'all do subscribe. Also, massive shout out to my boy Blake for letting me use his account to record this gameplay. He is one of very, very few people that I have seen be lucky enough to pull Shaq. So excited to try out this card. Obviously, Shaq is ridiculous. The big diesel, 7-1, 99 offense and defense, 99 stats basically across the board. I mean, he is an invincible card, an in-game card, whatever you want to call it. I mean, he is an extraordinary looking card. 45 Hall of Fame badges include, I mean, pretty close to most of the important Hall of Fame badges in the game. That's a pretty extraordinary number. And then when you look at the badges that he doesn't have on Hoff, I mean, it's shooting badges, Agent 3, Blinders, Deadeye, Guard Up, Limitless Range, Bailout, Handles for Days, I guess Unpluckable. It's basically a few playmaking badges and then a bunch of shooting badges. And then badges you can add to him. I mean, I 100% would add Break Starter, but outside of that, it's really nothing else important. Agent 3, I think, is one that needed to be added, but it looks like he already added Agent 3 on gold. So overall, this Shaq card, without a doubt, I mean, looks ridiculous. I think he might need a couple of badges added. He may not be ridiculously complete overall, but like, he's gonna be a pretty ridiculous card as an overall option. That drag back is pretty insane. I will say, movement wise, he's just not as good as Kareem. His between the legs is not as good as Kareem's is. His escape is certainly not as good as Kareem's is. His between the legs is still, or his drag back is still very good, but his behind the back is certainly not nearly as good as well. I don't think movement wise this Shaq is actually all that great, even with the release on very quick. Also, the release isn't extraordinary, but he certainly is a huge threat from the outside still. He's still insanely glitchy and insanely fast, and I think he's still a absolutely massive mismatch at the center spot, but his release is slow enough and ugly enough to where he's not going to be unstoppable and insanely glitchy as like a shooting threat, three hunting threat, especially considering the lack of extraordinary SIGs or anything like that. But Kyrie dribble style is really good, does give him a dribble style that can just burst off at anything, so I can just drag back and just move behind the back and just move like that. Kyrie dribble style does free up a lot offensively with Shaq. Overall, I do think this card is going to be ridiculous. I think he is going to be the second best card in the game after Kareem. He's still 100 overall. He's still ridiculously overpowered, and I'm incredibly excited to try the card out. So without further ado, let's use Shaquille O'Neal. Let's see what he can do. I feel bad for this dude, man. His team is not bad. D-Book, AD, KD. Who did he have at center? I didn't even see. And then for some reason, Series 2 SGA is a weird one. Oh, Elton Brand is his center. I'm going to be honest. This dude's team is not awful, but it is certainly not in, not even close to the level of team that we're working with here with Shaq. First and foremost, 100 overall Shaquille O'Neal, James Harden, Galaxy Opal, Kobe Bryant, and Miles Turner and Jason Tatum is just an absolutely absurd team. Driving to the rim, first possession, draws a foul, gonna go to the free throw line. Let's see what Shaq's free throw is. I assume he still has his own free throw. In fact, it looks like he does, which admittedly is not the best free throw release in the world, but at the same time, 100% right there, Hoff free points. He's not a bad free throw shooter anymore. Shaq hits both free throws and hits them easily. 2 points on the first possession for Shaquille O'Neal. I feel like this card is going to be borderline unstoppable against teams like this. I just think he can do everything that you would possibly want out of a card at a crazy high level, except for maybe shot create and kind of shoot, I will say. Like, I think he is a little more limited than Kareem in those areas, especially as a shot creator. Kareem had really crazy glitchy sigs, as crazy glitchy insane as Shaq is, and he does have some nice sigs and animations and stuff. I mean, he's ridiculous, no doubt. Look at the movement. I mean, just getting to the rim, that's absurd. He's not still, I would say, quite as glitchy in terms of some of his playmaking, especially the three hunting shot making ability from the outside as a guy like Kareem probably is. So as good as Shaq is, I'm not sure he's quite as good of a card as Kareem. At the same time, he's absolutely freaking insane. So let's go pick and pop behind the back here. James Harden attack the rim, back out to Shaq. Shaq dribbling here, same side. I can't really burst, but you know what? We're still at the rim, and Kyrie dribble style. That Kyrie dribble style kind of makes up for a lot of deficiencies as a shot creator if you use it properly, I will say. So that is a very, very nice positive. Stop and pop. I cannot stand the slowdowns that release is going to get when you're tired, though. I'm not going to lie. That's going to be a huge, huge negative, to be honest. When you're tired with this card, his slowdowns are going to be completely ungreenable. At the same time, I think he's basically as unstoppable as a slasher as it gets, and that was still a very impressive first game. So let's hop into one more game and let's keep dominating with 100 overall Shaquille O'Neal. All right, going up against Young King here, Jalen Green, Michael Finley. What in the... Did this dude just load up the game for the first time today? He has two Galaxy Opals, both Wild West cards, as well as Aldridge, Gordon Hayward, and Michael Finley. Literally a all Wild West team. Very strange. But D-Rob matched up against Shaq is the best matchup we realistically were going to get. I mean, that's about as good as it gets in terms of matchup. I don't think Shaq is all that dangerous as a shooter. I just don't. But his slashing ability with his speed and size and player build with that Kyrie dribble style is just unbelievable. The speed at which he gets to the rim and the aggression with which he seems to dunk the ball is pretty extraordinary. Hits the screen right there. You're really going to post up Shaq. That would be a pretty extraordinary decision, in my opinion. Throw the ball to me. I will take that. Gordon Hayward throws a steal. Kobe gets the steal, and apparently I somehow turned the ball over backcourt, handing the ball. Was I really seriously in the front court with Kobe and backcourt with Tatum? They were right next to each other, I guess. I don't know. That may have been just like the perfectly wrong spot somehow that I was in accidentally. Did not mean to do that. He gets inside but gets blocked. And you know what that means? That means Shaq has the ball, 99 speed. Oh, I didn't even mean to do that. That was a mistake. We'll get back though. We can recover and play multiple things. Get to the corner, contest there, step up. Good defense. Move your feet. Get back. Beautiful stuff. Rotate off the hash. Nothing is open. This dude doesn't know what he's doing. I'm not going to lie. I'm realizing the way that he's playing. I don't think he really knows what he's doing. And I don't think he's going to have many answers for Shaq once we see it cooking. Okay, he missed that one. That's fine. Let's see if we can get Shaq really cooking with the ball in his hands. Space the floor here. That Kyrie dribble style between the legs, burst, attack the rim. Look at this, bro. The speed and athleticism with which he gets to and gets on that rim is just incredible. And I think it makes him a top tier card regardless. I mean, one of the best, most overpowered cards you've really ever seen in my team, regardless of the lack of shooting. I think his release, even on very quick, is still really ugly, and I think that does limit him. Like, that's something that I didn't love Kareem's release on very quick, and I don't love Kareem's release on very quick, but I think it gives you a lot more than what you're realistically getting out of Shaq's release right now. But contest there, that's not open. Shaq should have the board, and actually Miles Turner gets the board on that one, but we'll run the floor again and throw it over to Shaq. Same side burst, attack downhill. Dude, this, look at the blow by. Look at the speed and the athletic ability at which he gets to the rim every single play. That is this card's best attribute, 100%. Everything else is nice. The ability to stretch the floor now is a positive. Like, you can't paint set off a Shaq, but at the same time, he is not going to be the threat as a shooter that you would probably hope he would be, where he will just be this incredible pick and pop big. That's still not really his role. He is certainly more of a slipper or even a ball handler himself. I think he can be really glitchy as the pick and roll ball handler, though, with that Kyrie dribble style especially. Try to attack the rim here. If I could just get an open three ball, that would be really nice, but the way this dude is just sitting in the corner, I'm not sure it's gonna happen. We're trying our best, I promise y'all we are, but swing okay, he dunks everything. He really glitz is, he is so glitchy on the inside. Like, I don't know This card is, if he had a really good release, he would be more unbalanced, I think, than Kareem, because his animations feel glitchier than Kareem in terms of how fast he is. And that Kyrie dribble style is so nice. I understand the SIGs aren't great, but the dribble style itself is just so, so nice in terms of actually being able to shot create with a big for once. Dump big, dump down, pop it back out, stop again, between the legs. He's gassed. We can just keep running. Hit our pop, catch and shoot Miles Turner. Remember, Shaq's a playmaker too. He's an insane rebounder. He does everything you need a big to do at an incredibly high level, basically. Catch here, he's exhausted. Only reason he missed that is because he's exhausted. 100 overall Shaq. Still does get tired, though, eventually. And he gets the rim with Michael Finley, gets a dunk, cuts it to only a two-point game. Minute 43 left here. Shaq, time to close out this game strong. I need a good execution here. Hit our pop, mismatch created, and let's just reject it. Oh my gosh, look at Shaq. Oh, dunking on multiple dudes. Easy contact slam. 100 overall Shaq is OP. You love to see it. Let's go. Get down here. Let's defend David Robinson. He's defensive three, offensive three. Hello. We'll take the offensive three on David Robinson. And there we go. 4-point lead, minute 24 left. If I can get a three, man, that would be the perfect cap to this video. Harden bursting, and I almost turned the ball over immediately. As soon as I go, if I could get a three, and I almost turned the ball over. I'm going to try to fade off this screen here because the way that he's playing defense, yo, that upper ruins his fade. I'm not going to lie. This Shaq as a three-point shooter is disappointing. I'm not totally shocked because his animations are really bad when it comes to his release and everything this year, but a little disappointed because I think his upper really kind of just ruins both his release and his, we knew his release wasn't going to be good, but his fade because of that upper is so darn ugly as well. As great as he is in so many ways, and he is incredibly good and very OP, he's not quite as good as you would expect a 100 overall card to be simply because of that upper ruining the release and hurting one of the more important parts about the card. The shooting ability is just one of the most important things at this point in the year about every single card. And if you're limited as a shooter, you're kind of just limited as a card overall. And that does not mean that Shaq is not one of the best cards in the game, but saying he's the second best card in the game might be gassing it because I don't know if I'm taking him over Kobe, Harden, SGA, LeBron, guys like that, my favorite cards in my team. Like, do I really want a 100 overall Shaquille O'Neal that's kind of a liability as a shooter because of his release? I think the answer to that might be no. With 22 seconds left, he's fouling. I don't want to play the foul game, and the game is over regardless. 12 points, 2 rebounds, and 1 block in that game, 5-7, and he played well in the first game as well. Shaq is a stud. He's really good, and yet I don't think it's ridiculous to say that he's a little bit disappointing as 100 overall. Regardless, he's still an incredible card, still one of the very best cards in the game, and he is still the second best center in the game behind only Kareem, in my opinion. I would still say he is better than D-Rob and Miles Turner and guys like that, even with the mediocre release, just because of how good he is as an overall card. So, hope y'all did enjoy the video. If you did, make sure you hit that like button, leave a comment, and subscribe. I'll be back with more 2K content very, very soon, and I appreciate y'all. Peace!